PNB has said that look, we need to build this tower because there's a lack of supply of office space in KL, and that this is actually a commercially viable project that can sustain us in terms of income and also give us good profits. What has not really been discussed publicly is the fact that there's over glut of office supply space in KL. So this is a report by Cushman Wakefield. You can see that this is the latest quarter, fourth quarter 2012. You can see a spike in the percentage of unoccupied office space here in KL, up to 25% already. Not only that, we see two big mega projects coming in. The Tun Razak Exchange, just off Jalan Tun Razak, will add another 4.7 million square feet over the next 15 years. Menara Warisan will add another 3 million square feet in the next 10 years. Right, so you can see, you are adding more space in an already oversupplied market. All these are other reports and newspaper articles that have been reported in the last 2 years. Klang Valley to face oversupply of office space. So when you add another 4 million square feet in this KLCBD in the form of the 118 tower, how sustainable is it going to be? Is it going to be another white elephant project after building this whole commercial project? Nobody wants to move in, and then it becomes something which is underutilized, which it could have been put to a much better use in terms of keeping it as a public space. Only those two buildings now are protected, listed as a national heritage building, so they cannot be touched. At least now lah, you know, because in Malaysia anything can happen. We can look to the National Heritage Act to try to protect not just these two stadiums, but the whole area around the stadium. Because if under Section 40, Article 40 of the National Heritage Act, when you want to apply for planning permission in a place in the heritage site, you also need to make sure that measures have been taken to ensure the safety of the heritage site and the neighboring land. Right, the land that is around Stadium Merdeka and Negara. So any approval or any application to want to build buildings around this Stadium Merdeka and Negara needs to take into account the protecting not just the integrity of these two buildings but also the character of these two buildings. The stadium complex was considered part of Taman Tunku as recent as the KL draft plan in 1987. Right, this is before the land was privatized and given to UEM, I think illegally. You look at the sports areas, Stadium Complex and Taman Tunku, they're considered as one area. How can they be separated out? Only the two stadiums designated as National Heritage Site and then Taman Tunku privatized and given to PNB to get developed. Right, so there's clearly something wrong here. Why was it this was a change? Vancouver Stanley Park has 1,001 acres and it has 500,000 trees. This is downtown Vancouver. This is downtown Vancouver. You just walk less than 5 minutes, you reach there already. Mexico City is one of the most congested cities in the whole world with over 20 million people. And yet, in the middle of Mexico City, they have a park that's 1,700 acres. So, given the fact that we have all these public parks around the world, right in the heart of very, very crowded cities, what we are asking for is actually not a lot. Stadium Complex and Taman Tunku, we're just asking for 30 acres. It's only 30 acres compared to the 1,000 acres, 800 acres that you can see in other major cities in the world. I think it's important for us not just to stop this Menara 118, but to actually restore Taman Tunku and ask the government to give this as the gift to the people, to restore this to the rightful place of the people so that we can enjoy it just like all these other major cities in the world.